Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. In this video, we will install the Android Studio software. Now, Android Studio is a professional software used by many developers around the world for developing Android apps. So, we are not going to develop Android apps, but when we download the Android Studio software, the Android SDK, that is the software development kit, gets downloaded along with it. And the software development kit is what we are interested in. Because when you create a VR game inside Unity, for building and running the Android game inside your Android smartphone, you need to provide the path of your software development kit. If the software development kit is not available, then you cannot build your VR game. Now, for downloading Android Studio inside your system, we first need to install two more softwares. The first software is the Java Runtime Environment or JRE. The second software is JDK, that is the Java Development Kit. And once both these softwares are installed, next, we will install Android Studio. But before downloading the JRE, JDK and the Android Studio, you should first know your system configurations. That is, whether your system is a 32-bit system or a 64-bit system. So to check the system configuration, I'll first open the File Explorer. Next, I'll right-click on this PC and after that, I'll click on Properties. Now, inside the Properties, as you can see, my system type is 64-bit, okay? So, I'll basically download the JRE and JDK software for the 64-bit operating system, okay? If your system is 32-bit, then in system type, it will show you 32-bit operating system. So, if your system is 32-bit, you should download the 32-bit softwares for your system, okay? So, after finding out the system configuration, next I'll go on Google and I will first type JRE free download for Windows 64-bit. So once I type this search command, next I'll click on this link, that is Java SE Runtime Environment. And you can see over here that this link is basically from the website Oracle. Okay. So guys, please make sure that when you're downloading the JRE and the JDK, you please open the links which are from Oracle. I'll also provide the JRE, JDK and the Android Studio link in the resource section. So this is the page for the Java Runtime Environment, and over here, if you look very carefully, that these are the softwares which you can download according to your system. Okay. So if you're using a Linux system, then you can choose any of these four options. If you have a Mac system, then you can choose between these two options. And if you have a Windows system, then you can choose between these options. Okay. Now, since my system is 64-bit, I'll download this software. If your system is 32-bit, then you can basically download this link, that is Windows x86 offline. Okay. Now, for downloading this link, I'll first click on accept license agreement, and after that I'll click on the Windows x64 offline option. Now guys, these Windows x64 and x86 softwares will work on Windows 7, Windows 8 and Windows 10. Okay. Now guys, after downloading the JRE, next I'll download the JDK. So to download the JDK, I will type JDK free download for Windows 64-bit. And I'll again search for the Oracle link. So I'll open this Oracle link. You can see over here, I have these options of Java Development Kit. So we have to download the Java Development Kit from these options. Okay. So again, if you have a Linux system, you can download these links. For Mac, you can download this Mac OS JDK. And if you have a Windows, you can choose between these two options. So if you have a Windows 32-bit system, you can download Windows x86. If you have a Windows 64-bit system, you should download this software link. Okay. So I'll click on accept license agreement. And after that, I'll click on JDK ATU121. Now guys, after downloading the JDK and the JRE, next I'll download the Android Studio software. So in the search field, I'll type Android Studio download. Now, as you can see, this is the first link for downloading Android Studio. So I'll open this link. Now, once you go on this link, you have to click on this green button to download Android Studio inside your system. So I'll agree to the terms and condition. And after that, I'll click on download Android Studio for Windows. So guys, as you can see, I've basically downloaded all the three softwares inside my system and I've copied them inside this folder called as softwares. So since this is the latest version of JRE, we'll basically install it. Okay. So to install the JRE, I'll double click on the JRE file. I'll then click on yes. So I'll click on install. The installation of Java Runtime Environment is very simple. You just have to click on Next. Okay, so you'll basically get some buttons where you have to click on Next, Next, Next. I'll again click on the Next button. Okay, so as you can see, the Java Runtime Environment is installed in my system. So next, I'll click on the Close button. And after installing the JRE, next, I'll install the JDK. I'll click on Yes again. So I'll basically wait for the setup to load. So I'll click on Next. After this, I'll again click on Next. So I'll again click on the Next button. So the installation of JDK is complete. So I'll click on the Close button. So guys, after installing the JRE and the JDK, next I'll install the main software, that is Android Studio. So as you can see, the setup file is loading now. So guys, this is the main Android Studio setup. So I'll click on the Next button over here. After this, I need to download the Android SDK and the Android Virtual Device. So I'll click on Next again. I'll click on I agree. Now guys, if you look at this first location, then this first location is where your Android Studio software will be downloaded and installed. And if you look at the second location, then the second location is where the SDK components will be installed. So guys, please note down the path of your SDK. Okay, so if you can see in my system, the path is C users dinesh app data local Android SDK. Okay, so please note down this location, because later on we need to trace this SDK path and we need to provide this SDK path inside a Unity software. After this, I'll click on the Next button. I'll again click on the Next button, and at the last I'll click on Finish. Okay, so I'll click on the Android Studio option, which has come at the taskbar. So guys, as you can see, Android Studio is basically asking me that whether I have an SDK installed previously or not. Okay, so since we are installing the Android Studio for the first time, obviously we won't have the SDK. So to download the SDK, I'll choose this last option, that is, I do not have a previous version of Android Studio and I do not want to import my settings. And after that, I'll click on OK. So now, as you can see, Android Studio is basically opening in my system. Okay, so once Android Studio is open, I'll click on the Next button again. Now Android Studio is asking me to choose an install type, so I'll choose the standard option. I'll click on Next again. So now, as you can see, that these are the SDK components which will be downloaded now. Okay, and the total size of these components is approximately around 973 MB. Okay, so I'll just click on the Finish button and the downloading will start right now. So guys, this download process will take some time depending on your internet connection. So guys, as you can see, the SDK components are downloaded in my system. So next, I'll click on Finish. Now guys, if you're seeing this window, then that means Android Studio is installed in your system. Okay. So next, let's create a new Android Studio application. So to create an Android app, I'll click on this option which says start a new Android Studio project. I'll give my project a name of first application. And as you can see, like, this is the company domain. So the company domain basically stands for your package, because as you can see at the bottom, the package name is basically the reverse of the company domain and the application name. That is, the package name is com.example.dinesh.firstapplication. Okay. So the package name is a combination of application name and company domain, and this is the location where your project is stored. So I'll click on Next again. Then I'll again click on next. After this, I'll click on next. Now, the best part of Android Studio is that when you design an Android app, there are multiple layouts available. Okay, so I'll just choose this empty activity and then I'll click on next. And after this, I'll click on finish. So now, as you can see, my Android Studio application is building over here. So guys, as you can see, my Android application is open inside the Android Studio editor. Okay, and this is just a small tip. And this is the sample Android code. Okay. So guys, we're basically finished installing the Android Studio software. And we have also created a new application called as the first application. So guys, that's it from this video. And in the next video, we will link the Android SDK to the Unity software. I hope you would have liked this video. This was a free video from my virtual reality course, which is available on Udemy. This course is currently priced at $200, but you can get it at a discounted price of just $10 by clicking on the link in the description. So, if you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more amazing videos like these. Thank you guys, and I'll see you in the next video.